Hey guys, it's Dan, and I wanted to make a video explaining something new that the MTA is doing to help you guys out. If you haven't seen any of the ads on buses, posters in buses, and subway stations, or anywhere you might get helpful information, the MTA is releasing a program where you can track bus locations in real time. This program is called BusTime, and is currently rolled out at the time of filming in Staten Island, Bronx, Manhattan, and two routes in Brooklyn, the B61 and the B63. March 9th is when we will have all other buses in Brooklyn put online in the BusTime network, as well as all of the bus routes in Queens. This will really help with people that are standing in the sweltering heat or in the freezing cold waiting for the bus, by eliminating that and you meeting the bus. BusTime has its limitations, and this is an important note that I will make. First of all, BusTime does not give you the time it will take the bus to reach your stop. You will have to take into account a lot of things, like the weather, traffic, and other people that may be making the bus hold at stops. BusTime will only give you the location. Another drawback is that it updates once every 30 seconds. If you try to refresh the info, it will only show you the history. That's pretty much false advertising for the MTA that says it's in real time, but when you think in the long run, it actually is. And let's get the show on the road. First, I will show you the computer part, then the mobile, and finally the text messaging part. So when you get on your computer and want to know the location of the bus in the web address bar in your favorite web browser, I'm using Chrome, you will type in bustime.mta.info. That's bustime.mta.info. You will see two main things on the screen, a map that quite frankly does not show anything yet, and a search bar right here. Obviously, you will start with the search bar and type any one of the following: a route, such as the B63, S62, and X1, an intersection, such as Main Street and Craig Avenue, a stop code, which is 6 digits, example here being the 200884, and location. Now, location can be either one of these things. It can be an address, intersection, zip code, whatever the hell you want. When you type in a route, you will get the entire route map and all the buses that are currently on it. Here, I'm using the B63, as you can see. Type an intersection in, you will get all of the closest routes to that intersection. In this case, I typed in Main Street and Craig Avenue, well, I actually clicked it as one of the examples, and what I got is these bus routes. Now, at any point, you can actually hover over one of them, and it will highlight that route on the map. Type a stop code, it will actually show you that bus stop on the map and show you the closest buses to that bus stop. In this case, I'm using one of the examples provided for me, stop code 200884, which gives me Henderson Avenue and Westbury Avenue. On the bubble, you will see all of the closest buses to that bus stop and their distance away from it. Remember, the keyword is distance, not time. At the bottom of the bubble, there will be a hint on how to find out locations from a mobile device. Smartphones have their own website, which I will go over right now. Now, I pulled up my Nexus 4 and opened up Chrome, because that is the only web browser that I have. But if you have an iPhone, you go Safari. Basically, you can use any smartphone for this. So, your web address bar, you type the same thing in, bustime.mta.info. Obviously, you got that saved. I'm just going to click it. Now, this is a familiar search bar because that's what we saw on the website, on the PC, on the computer. You also got these suggestions, but obviously these are all examples. Your actual stop may vary. But we're going to use the example that we were provided with, and that is stop code 200884 for Henderson Avenue and Westbury Avenue. This is actually familiar. This is actually from the bubble. Now, one thing is that there's no map. This is flat out on the web page. If you want to get to the map, you go to this little link that says desktop site. Of course, I'm not going to go on it because I want to show you the mobile site. Now, here is where the stop name is. This is where all the routes are, and these are the closest buses to that bus stop. One thing is that the mobile version does not refresh itself. What you have here is actually a refresh button. Now, you can click that, and I'll refresh it for you, or you can click the web browser refresh button. Both work the same way. Now for texting, you can actually use any phone, obviously, because all phones have text messaging. In the toolbox, instead of writing down a phone number, you're actually typing this 6-digit code, 511123. In the message, you can type in a stop code or intersection. So let's stick with the example. Oh, 200884. Send the message, and within seconds, this is what you will get. A reply, an automatic reply, obviously. It will show you the stop code, just confirming it. It will show you the routes and the closest buses to that stop. Additionally, because text messages don't allow refreshes automatically, you have to type in the letter R, send it, and once again, a couple of moments, you will get a reply back with the updated version of the stop. Oh, now it's 0.2 miles closer. Nice, time to get outside and yeah. Just catch the bus. But obviously I don't live in Staten Island, I'm just making things up. But I hope you find this helpful. If you want, you can share this video to anybody who may wish to know how to use this. But in the meantime, it is Dan signing out.